students. Good morning. Today we are away from school due to pandemic. But we are trying our best to give you whatever we can. And this is only possible due to technology available with us. Let's move ahead with a positive attitude and make the best out of it. And here I am, your science teacher. Today, we shall take the subject science. I am your science teacher. My name is Kiran Tejuja. Let's see what do we have today for you. Children, you are sitting in your house. But just see to your left and your right, there are many things placed in your house, somewhat like this. You can see walls around you. You can see a table. You can see a chair. Books, bags, stationery, I'm sure, a fridge, a television, right? You can see all the things around you. Very good. I have something on the screen also for you and many more things beyond that also. Do you know all the objects around you are made up of atoms? All the objects around you are made up of atoms. I'm sure you will be surprised if I tell you. Now, these atoms are electrically charged particles. And if I say that all the objects that you are using are having charge in them, they are electrically charged. Are you surprised? And the big question will now come into your minds that teacher, if they are electrically charged, if they are having some electricity current in them, why don't we feel the current? Why don't we feel the shock when we touch them? Do you want the answer to this question? Yes, sure. I will tell you all the answers to your question and I will satisfy all your curiosities through this chapter. That is chapter number 4, current, electricity and magnetism, right? So today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is current, electricity and magnetism. Before I move forward, I would like to satisfy your query first. Teacher, why don't we get a shock with electric current? These are the learning outcomes which we are going to achieve from today's learning, today's lecture. Let's see about the objects around you now. Now, I told you all the objects are made up of atoms. Now, the atoms are made up of protons, neutrons, and electrons. And we all know this is the picture where we denote as atom. See, they are having negatively charged particles, they are having positively charged particles and also some neutrons. See, there is no blast occurring. There is lots of energy stored in the nucleus. And when all the positive charge want to come out, the negative electrons do not allow them to come blast. They keep the whole atom intact. Now, why don't you get a current? Why don't you get a shock out of it? That is because an atom has same number of positively charged protons and negatively charged electrons. When there are same number, it gets nullified. It gets neutralized. So you do not feel the current in them. Let's go ahead. After satisfying you, your curiosity, let's learn what is there in this lesson. Now, I am showing something to you on the screen. See, before I start this activity, I want you to know all this energy which was present in your objects, like the table, the chair, and the things there. They had static electricity in it. They were not moving. And to make them move, what will happen? You will have to apply some external force to it. Let's see how this moving will happen through an activity here. I will just want you to recall your earlier days where maybe in a classroom you have done sometime by taking a plastic ruler in your hands and rubbing it on your head and placing it over the bits of paper. I'm sure you must have observed that the bits of paper get attracted to the plastic skein. The same principle is applied here in this activity. We have a glass rod and a silk cloth. When we rub the glass rod, it gains energy. It becomes moving. The static energy into it, the static electrical energy into it gets charged. And the protons and neutrons start moving. Now what happens here? See, when you rub this silk cloth on the glass rod achieves positive nature. The glass rod receives positive charge on it. Children, a little example for you, just to remember and recall everything. See, when you give something to others, you are said to have a positive attitude. That means you are having a good nature. And positive attitude here is denoted as positive charge. See, when you have something more, only then you can give it to others. And that is denoted by plus sign, that is positive. On the other side, the negative energy is there on the silk cloth. See, negative denotes that you are asking something from others. Asking is a bad habit. Asking things from others is not a good habit. It's a negative attitude. So that makes the charge negative on the silk cloth. Now, to sum it up, we will say when a glass rod is rubbed against the silk cloth, it gets electrically charged. Let's see what happens in our daily life. Children, you see there is lightning. See, it's a monsoon season. There is lots of rain coming out, but sometimes you see a loud thunder. A loud thunder. Before that, you see a little lightning in the sky. A spark coming out from the clouds and coming towards the earth. It has lots and lots of electrical energy in it. And till it reaches us, it becomes lesser and lesser. That means it reduces to the most extent when it reaches us. So we do not get affected to it. But sometimes we have also heard that people say, mother, teachers, they all tell you, please do not keep your mobiles on charge when there is lots of lightning in the sky. We have always heard about it. Now, why is that? Because it may catch current because of lots of energy in them. The same thing happens in our brain. The microscopically small current is felt in our brain, especially when we are under stress. See, there are sparks in our brain. The nerves are activated and our brain starts working more faster. We have to feel that. Let's see. Now you want to make the current flow. Correct. all these things are stagnant and you want to make the current flow. This needs a medium. We can make the current flow through the wires around us, in the electricity current which is coming in our house, and also in the bulbs. We can make the current flow here, the electrical appliances. All these appliances are used in our houses. The mixer, the fridge, the fan, everything runs on electricity. Let's see. Now, you want to know how it flows. I want to tell you that if you keep a bucket of water on a height and another bucket at the lower position, always we have observed, if you spill something on the bench or on the higher altitude, definitely the water flows downward. That means we can sum it up by saying water flows spontaneously from the higher level to the lower level. Similarly, we can say when we test a temperature of any object, we touch some temperature on the with our hands or with the thermometer. Sometimes we cook food in our house. My mother cooks food in the house and she says, this vessel is too hot, do not touch it. What do? You put it under a running water and all the temperature goes down with the running water. See, here in the picture we have seen the temperature also moves from higher level to the lower level. Children, here I would like to tell you that similarly, if you want to flow the current also moves from higher electrical level to the lower electrical level. Now, positive indicates a higher level. You have lots and lots of it. Hence, you can give it to others. And from higher electrical level to the lower electrical level. Let's see how you can allow it to move. Children, everyone has some potential in it. This is called electrostatic potential. Let's see what it is. The electric level deciding the direction of flow of electric charge is called electrostatic potential. I told you everything, every object has energy stored in that, electrical energy stored in that. But you want to make use of it now. So we have to see the potential difference. At higher level how much it is and at lower level how much it is, and the difference between two. The difference between the higher level and the lower level is called the potential difference. Children, what is potential? Potential means the capacity, the capability of a person to do some work. For example, you are a child and if I tell you to push a cupboard all alone, it is not possible for a single child to do that. It is not possible for a single child to do that. You will require many people to do. So here I will tell you the potential difference is the difference between the potentials of two points is called potential difference. See, there is cold and hot zero. The difference between these temperatures is called the potential difference. And here the water is falling from the height to the lower level. The difference between these two potential is called potential difference. Now, there is some unit for each thing. If you want to measure it, if you want to know how much is the calculation, you have to say the unit of potential difference in the SI system is volts. It is denoted by V. Let's see. I want to make this electricity flow. It is not possible a thing to get up and go itself. I need some current to flow in it. For that, I will do an activity. You too can do it at home yourself. Children, I have shown you a bulb here. A bulb is connected to the copper wire. I have connected a bulb to the copper wire. See, there is a copper wire wound around, and I have tried to make a circuit out of it. But children, still my bulb is not glowing. If I want this bulb to glow, I need some external force to be applied to it. Now, how do I apply the force? I have a wire, I have a bulb, but I have to work on it. See, this is something which I have added. This is something which I have added, and this is called a cell. A cell will give energy. A cell will give the force for the current to flow. You know, you need to have a push for everything. If the ball is stagnant there, it will not move. It will remain there for years and years unless someone comes and kicks it out. So I have placed a cell. Remember, I'm telling you, a cell has a negative terminal and a positive terminal. Every time it is not possible for us in a circuit diagram to draw a cell, so we denote it by this sign, a plus sign and a negative sign. Now, the moment I put the battery in it, the cell in it, my current starts flowing. See, I have shown this current by the arrow here, and my bulb starts glowing. Here I would highlight on one thing is the current has started flowing, but there is a direction to that flow. And what is the direction here? From the positive terminal, it goes to the bulb and then it goes to the negative terminal. Only then your circuit will be complete. Correct? The direction is decided by the cell which you have used. Let's see forward. Can you measure the flow of current? But before that, I will give you an example. Think about it. If you have to measure the flow of water, you have a big pipe and the water is flowing out. I want to measure the flow of water here. What will we do? We can find it from the amount of water in liters. Everything has a unit, I said, in a coming out in a specific period. For example, in 1 minute or in 1 second or in 1 hour, as per the amount of water, I'm going to decide that the water is coming out. We measure the water in that specific period and you come to know how many liters per second, how many liters per minute, or how many liters, X liters in per hour. Now, you can also measure this. Of course, when I can measure current, water flowing, I will want to know how current also should be measured. Current can also be measured by electrical charge through a wire in 1 second. That is called a unit current. Unit means one. How will you measure it? The electric charge which is flowing through the wire in 1 second is called a unit current. I want to measure it now. The SI unit of electric current is coulomb per second. It is also said to be as ampere. 1 ampere will be equal to, is denoted as 1A, and that is equal to 1 coulomb per 1 second. It is written as 1C per 1S. Now, let's move forward for the next unit in our chapter. Now, the cells. There are lots of cells available in the market. But before that, you want to know what does a cell do. As in earlier part, I had said, I need a cell to give a kick start to the circuit, to make the circuit moving, which is stagnant and still. I want to make it moving. So if you want to make it moving, you require a source. A source is required to produce a flow of charge in a circuit. Such a device is called an electric cell. Now, these types of cells are available in the market. All of you have seen. Where do we use them? Just recall them fast. We use them in our day-to-day life as per our requirement. There are very small pencil cells, smaller than that. There are box cells. There are little coin type cells also, which we use in our calculators and our wristwatches. Let's see, where do we use them? We use them in the transistors, radios, in our wall clocks. I'm sure in the classroom, everybody must have changed their batteries. Cells have been changed over a period, it gets stopped, so we change them. Everyone, I'm sure, knows about the cell we use in our clocks, and we also use them in the torches and many more places. I'm sure you are having toys in your house, correct? You have toys in which also sometimes you have to place one cell or a two cell or maybe four also.
Let's see. Remote control.
Yeah, very good. I rightly said there is a small ones. See, these are the small ones. The smaller ones, we use them in the remote controls. And without a remote control, nobody lives in the house nowadays. So let's see how is this cell made and how does it work. So let's cut open this cell. I'm not telling you to cut open a new cell, but sometimes children have the habit. Curiosity leads to that thing. What you will do, if you have an old cell, what happens? You will cut it open with a plate, and the moment you cut open, you see some liquid in it. Let's start with the outer covering. The outermost covering is colorful. You may have blue color, you may have red color. Some cells are having black and golden colors. I will not name the brand of this cell. We are not here to learn about the brand of the cell. Many companies are giving different names to that cell. We are going to learn here with the internal working of this cell. This is called a dry cell. When you cut it open, the outermost shining layer, which is the actual container, that is made up of zinc element. That is made up of zinc element, and that zinc here acts as a negative terminal. We said earlier, you need to complete your circuit only if you have a positive terminal and a negative terminal. So zinc acts here as a negative terminal. Now I will jump to the positive terminal. The carbon rod you can see here. When you cut it open, there is a black rod used here and little bit it is protruded. You can see a plus sign written here. This is a carbon rod. See, this is a carbon rod, and this rod acts as a positive terminal in this cell. Now, how does the flow of current take place? We do not feel it, but we experience it when you put it in your remote controls. After a long period, it gets wear off. It is gone spoiled. But the happening of transfer of electrons and protons have to be done with a medium. A medium is required to see how it is transferred. For example, you have blood in your body. In blood also, what it does, it acts as a medium. The exchange of gases take place here. Carbon dioxide and oxygen are exchanged and our living goes on. Similarly, everything needs a medium. Now, this is a medium, and medium should be a little liquidy. It should be little liquid so that there is transfer of electrons happening easily. Now, here they have used a paste of ammonium chloride and also manganese dioxide. This is a shield. This is a layer of paste of ammonium chloride, and the inner part, which is a liquid, is manganese dioxide. they act as a medium. Here I will highlight that if a remote control, if your toy car is not used for a longer period, you must have observed a brown colored liquid flowing out of the cell, and it spoils the inner cover of your thing also. The object also gets spoiled, and this is because there is moisture in our air. This is the only drawback of this cell. If you put it near the moisture or in the water where there is water content, the cell gets spoiled. There is leakage from the cell over a period. But otherwise, this cell is most convenient in our life. We use it in our everyday things. And you can also store it. Some people keep it in their drawers. And you can also carry them in your pockets wherever you go. And it is very easy to place them and remove them from your objects. These are very convenient and they have a longer shelf life too. Now let's see another type of cell. This is a lead acid cell. Children, you can see a picture here. As the name suggests, this is lead. Lead is denoted by Pb. Lead dioxide is acting as a positive terminal here, and there is a rod made up of lead dioxide, and the negative terminal is the lead rod, a rod made by lead. But as I said earlier also, we need a medium. The medium here to work on with the cell used is dilute sulfuric acid. You can see the formula written here, H2SO4. This is a dilute sulfuric acid, and this acts as an electrolyte in the cell. This is a medium in which the positive and the negative protons and neutrons get exchanged and transferred to get energy, electrical energy from them. The importance of this cell is also they are rechargeable. They are rechargeable and they have a potential difference of 2 volts. Now let's see, where are these cells used? Have you seen this type of battery somewhere? I'm sure you have seen.
Yes, miss.
Very good. You have seen this. You have seen them in a car, a trucks, a fire brigade, an ambulance, all the vehicles which we use. See, these are the vehicles, but you have to fit them in it, and it is one drawback is it is heavy to use. You cannot use them as you used your batteries. You cannot put them in a pocket and take. I told you it is rechargeable. What do you mean by rechargeable? Sometimes when you don't use your car for a longer period, and like lockdown is going on, people are not using their cars. After many days, when you go and switch it on, it gives a ignition, right? And the battery goes down. It becomes, the battery is not working. So what you do? You take it and go to the car mechanic and get it charged again, and then your car starts. Let's go to the other type of cell, that is nickel cadmium cell. Nickel is an element in our periodic table, and cadmium is also another. As the name suggests, this is a nickel made up of nickel and cadmium. The best part of this cell is, see, this is a holder in which you can place these batteries and you can recharge them. The most important part of this is you can recharge them. Now, sometimes you have a toy car which needs lots of energy to run it. Now, toy car, if in 1 hour your batteries are over, and you keep purchasing your car, your mother will scold you and she will not allow you to buy. So what do you do? Once for all, you purchase this and you keep on recharging through your electric current. How we charge our mobile phones? In the same way, you can charge, plug in here and charge them. The potential difference here is, let's see, 1.2 volts. But mainly these type of cells are used by photographers. The photographers
in cameras,
very good. They have to go for wedding shoots and all. So lots of batteries they have to use. So they will recharge them every day and come for the next shoot. Let's see another type. See, they are used in cameras and your remote controlled cars. Correct. Now the next type of cell we should see is the lithium ion cell. Everybody has seen
mobile battery.
Huh? Mobile battery.
Mobile. Very good.
Yes,
I need not tell you. This is again rechargeable. So I will not talk over it. Just remember the name.
Battery.
This is lithium ion cell. Remember the name of it. I may ask you later. This is also rechargeable. Everybody puts your mobile on recharge. And this is having more electrical energy than the nickel cadmium cells. They are used in smartphones and laptops. Let's go to the next unit, that is magnetism. Now, here, nothing to do with the magnets. Actually, we use magnets, but here we are going to make some magnets temporarily. Let's see what is magnetism first. When an electric current passes through a wire, a magnetic field is produced around the wire. Let's see how we can do with this activity. Here I have used a battery. A cell is used. I have taken a copper wire. Children, you can also do it in your house when you are having these types of materials. You have to use a copper wire. Just wind it around a big iron nail. This is an iron nail used here. A big iron nail, you can coil it around and again to the negative terminal they have. What you have done is, you have made a circuit. See, only if the circuit is complete, your electric current will flow. Now, this is called an electromagnet because you are passing current in it, that is electricity current, and you are making a magnet yourself. You want to make a magnet yourself. What happens and how does it work? Let me explain you through this diagram. See, I have used a battery here. I have connected a copper wire. I have used an iron nail here. And it is coiled around this iron nail. I have kept some iron filings. We did not have iron filings. So we have used iron clips, which we use for paper clips, you can say. And for convenience, we have used a switch. Now the switch is on the off position. So no current is flowing. Do you want to know how the current flows? You put it on. The moment I put it on, the current starts flowing. Now the direction of the flow has decided. You have to tell me what is the current direction decided here. See, this is the positive terminal. I told you the carbon rod.
Miss, from positive to negative.
Lovely. From positive to the negative. See, it ends up here at negative. The current starts and immediately the coil gets current and there is a magnetic field produced here. The magnetic field is produced here and due to this magnetism, see what happens. All the iron clips get attracted to the iron nail. Here I would again mention, this is not a permanent magnet. The moment the current is stopped again, the iron filings go back to its position. They are released back and the magnetic field is lost. Correct? Are you all going to try this at home? And if you do,
yes,
please
miss.
Send me the videos of it.
Yes, miss.
You are going to send me the videos.
Miss, it is in in temporary kind, no miss?
Yes, sir. I again mentioned it 2-3 times. This magnetic field, this property is a temporary phase. It is not a permanent magnet. So let's see what are the things which are moving, which are using this principle in our day-to-day life. The first thing, every day you have seen in your school, a bell, electric bell working. See, this is an electric bulb in your school. So I will tell you, just recall the sound of the bell in your school. I will help you understand how does it work. The same principle which I told you, a temporary magnetic field is created. You are creating the temporary magnetic field. Let's see how. See, there are iron rods here. These are the iron rods. And what I told you earlier, you have to use a copper wire and coil it around the rods. Can you see this spring-like thing here? These are the coils of copper wire. What I have done?
Copper wire.
Simple iron. Simple iron. This is not a magnet, children. This is not a magnet. This is just a iron rod. And I have coiled, and we have coiled that copper wire around it nicely. And I have made a circuit here. See, there is a circuit. What is this? Source of energy. Electrical energy in the form of electric current or in the form of battery is kept here. Now, I have made this circuit complete by putting a contact screw here. This is an iron strip I have used, a thin strip we use here. And this strip is connected to the contact screw. Now, what happens here? This strip is connected to a striker. Here, there is a hard iron piece. We call it a striker. The striker, which we also use it in the carom board. And this is the big gong. The more bigger the gong is, the more louder the sound will be. Let's see how it works. As soon as you press the key, in the school, we press the switch button. The moment you press the switch button, the current starts flowing through this circuit and the contact here, which is attached, a magnetic field is created in this circuit. Correct? And the moment the magnetic field is created, this iron becomes a temporary magnet now. The moment it becomes a magnet, you know, magnets have property to attract iron. Now, this iron strip immediately gets attracted here. Am I clear? This iron strip immediately gets attracted to this and the circuit here breaks. The contact screw circuit breaks. But when the iron strip hits here, when it gets in contact here, the striker starts hitting the gong and you hear the loud gong of the bell. But here again, one thing happens. The moment the circuit breaks, the connection breaks. The connection breaks, the magnetic field is lost. And the iron strip goes back to its position and the sound of the gong is not heard anymore. The sound of the gong is stopped. So, do you understand how the electric bell is now working here? Am I clear?
Yes. Yes.
Let's see what we have learned in all this one, this lecture. Let's see, we have learned the flowing of current electricity through circuit. Everybody is going to make a circuit and show me now. The types of cells, the different types of cells we have used here. I will not name them all because we have already covered them. The magnetism, the temporary magnetism which was created due to the electric current and also the working of a bell. Now, I want to test your knowledge. You give me permission to test your knowledge? So, first question, please do not give me chorus answers. I will take your name, only then you will answer. What is the unit of electric current? Yes, Vedant. Unmute yourself and answer. Vedant. Vedant Dhanraj, unmute yourself and answer my question.
Apple.
Yes, beta, say.
Magnet.
Sorry. I cannot hear you.
Magnet.
Okay.
Sorry, Tita.
I could not get you. Okay, fine.
Ampere.
Sorry. It's not ampere. It's ampere. Ampere. you have to learn to pronounce it as ampere. Very good, very good. I heard somebody saying. Let's go to the next question. That is, where are dry cells used? Everybody knows this answer. Yes. Kaushal, answer.
Machine, clock, remote control, toys.
Lovely,
and remotes.
Very good. Now, what does this sign indicate? This sign indicates dash.
It's a circuit.
Circuit. No.
Cell.
Cell. Very good. A cell. The source of electrical energy. Yes. The next question comes on your screen is, name the acid used in the acid cell. What was the name of the acid used?
It's a sulfuric acid.
Very good. It was dilute sulfuric acid and the symbol to it was H2SO4. Very good. The last question on your screen is, which cell
is... What 2 volt ka hota hai?
It's a lithium ion cell.
Very good. The cell which is used in smartphones, you had told me earlier only, but still I had to ask this question to you. So I want to give you some homework also. I want to give you some homework today. My homework is you have to draw the diagrams of your electric current and the screw which we had made, the current flowing in the screw. Those two diagrams, you have to draw them neatly and you have to label them and send me pictures of it. And children, yes, you have to draw it in your science notebooks and send me the pictures. Do not forget to label them. Label them. Here I end up my lecture and we meet for the next lecture. Till then, stay home, stay safe, keep washing hands, do not go out of the house.